Morning is breaking, like the first morning. Now we're gonna go up some ways and then drop down into the riverbed, or for that matter, we can actually try and find a new road and go straight down into the riverbed. I think that's a better idea. Change of plans. To find a new way down to the riverbed so we can do the riverbed from the bottom up. Give you a picture. I'm going to try and join the riverbed where we finished the last one on the other side of this fence. There's a duiker straight up in the saw it. It's behind those bushes now. I want to drop down here to get into the sand to get out of the grass, because the grass seeds are going into the radiator. I'm driving along and I'm looking at the satellite images, because I know where I need to go. It's not that I'm lost. I'm trying to find the straightest path through, and the bigger sandy stretches will open up on the left hand side soon. To go from the left to the right of the riverbed, now we have to go back to the left of the riverbed, left side of it. See, now it looks, we had to go from one side to the other side all the time like that. I think I'm getting lost. I think I'm making a mistake here. What does it look like? I'm seeing the ostriches on my left hand side. That doesn't seem right. Just for a minute, let's just zoom out and see if I'm doing this right. I feel like I'm getting lost. I am seeing ostriches to my left. The ostriches are in the middle of the camp and I'm following the wrong river. That's nice. You see, there it's again. I have to go back there. I went up the wrong riverbed. I have to go back to that point and then go over. I went too far to the right. So let's correct that. Right, so I got lost. Just right after saying that I'm not lost and I'm not using the... I'll blame it on GPS, looking at the satellite images. Anyways, what happens is I zoomed in too close to see the details and I lost sight of the big picture, not realizing that I went up the wrong fork where the roads converge, where the rivers converge. I can't seem to find this wide open area. It's part of the riverbed, but it's going uphill. If I go there, I go uphill. And it doesn't look like that on the GPS. Oh, I'm gonna do it the long way, but the proper way. I'm gonna go down to where I messed up. in the other riverbed now, but it's against a slope, which is not really what it it's normally like. I think what's baffling me is that the erosion over the centuries haven't yet eroded this down to a riverbed. It's very wide, it's down a steep slope, so the water would be picking up speed, which normally means it erodes more, but it didn't. I'm wondering why. What got me is that it looks, on the satellite images, it looks exactly like the other riverbed. But here on the ground, it doesn't. It looks completely different. It looks more like just normal felt. We can go to the right here. I'm gonna put the camera outside for a while. I think it gives a better view of what's going on. This looks better. This looks. You can see if you look to the right, you can see how much higher this riverbed is than that one. Much, much higher. And that's why it goes down in that way over the side of the hill. Maybe on the right hand side, maybe if I change the angle that I'm coming in. And before I attempt it, I need to look at what's going to happen at the top there. I don't want to damage the car going up and then have to go back down again. We'll have to see if this is possible. This seems a bit less extreme. The problem is this, you have to be very close to this and go more to the left and then turn right and go up. And that seems possible to do. I think that's doable. Straddle this hole. Left wheel going up there, but the front wheel is going to have to go wide enough so that the rear wheel can still cross over, that the rear wheel doesn't drop into the hole, because I have to make a turn to the right here. The question is, what's going to happen up here? There's enough of a gap through here. This is quite narrow. This gap is just wide enough. You can climb over this, drop down the other side. I think that's fine. Question is whether you're going to go straight up this then. Seems okay. You would then exit it here and then go where? Is there an opening through? No, there isn't. Can't possibly be opened up. I think this is loose. This is loose. So I can open this up. So this is possible. Coming through there. And then it's a fairly easy climb up here. And we're through the first one. I'm working from the exit to this obstacle down towards the entry to the obstacle. I'm taking a risk coming here alone, taking a risk doing the obstacle with no recovery vehicle or help or anything. I'm also increasing the risk by doing a trail that nobody's ever done before. No vehicle's been through here. I'm mitigating those risks by planning every part of the obstacle from the start. I'm also mitigating the risk by not entering the obstacle unless I know exactly how I'm going to exit it. And the last mitigation of risk is the entry is the most difficult part. If I cannot enter it, I go back. Easy. Let's do this. Now the next difficult part is to find a good camera angle. That's not so easy. No, I have to think through this again. I can't go up this. I'm not going to have the approach angle for this. I mean, this is about 500 vertical. I don't have that. The wheel's going to have to go up here and then up here. So I'm going to have to go at an angle leaning slightly. It's only a slight lean to this side, it's not much. One of the things I struggle with the editing is sometimes I have to stop a video, it's getting too long. My computer can't handle all the footage in one go to do all the rendering or whatever it's called in one go. I don't want to stop on a cliffhanger, but I've already done that one, so it's not a cliffhanger that much. But I'm going to stop the video here. I'm going to continue driving through the rest, but I'm going to make it a separate video just because that makes it easier for me to edit. And more palatable bite-size videos as well. So that's it for now. See you on the next one. Cheers.